any moment now, the 15 minutes will be up. There we go. Shuts it off.
GoPro. Hello from sunny Alabama on this late March coronavirus quarantine day. Not much else to do, so I figured I'd do a mod. This mod involves an automatic shutoff for my water pump. I had previously installed water pump switches both in the bathroom and in the galley area. This automatic water pump shutoff is just a timer that takes the place of a switch. So it's as if you're pushing the switch off. I've got the timer set for 15 minutes, and let me show you how this all works. Here's my water pump switch. Just turn it on, and if I forget to turn it off, or if I leave the van, go for a walk or a bike ride or whatever, and I forget to turn it off, it will shut off in 15 minutes. And I think that's a safety feature that I like to have. At night when I go to bed, if I forget to shut it off, I don't have to get back out of bed. So here we go. All right, I'm going to activate the water pump. Water pump is powered, activated, and the timer has started. Timer is 900 seconds. Which is 15 minutes. I moved the module up to the side so it wouldn't get wet. And about 14 and a half minutes from now, I will record what it does. All right, this is a depiction of the water pump module. And it's got the switch contact, the battery contact, ground contact, and load contact. What happens when you turn the water pump switch on is the ground connects momentarily to the switch and it causes the load to open. So the load and battery are connected to the water pump and the water pump stays on. The next time you push the momentary switch or the one place switch, the ground momentarily connects to switch and it shuts off the load. Okay, so how these momentary switches work is the black and the red just powers the ring light. So if you connect the red to the battery and the black to the load, when you push the momentary switch, it causes the load to connect to the circuit and the ring light comes on. It also causes the water pump to come on. When you push it again, causing the ground to bridge over to the switch, it shuts the load off and the ring light comes off. So what I've done is I've taken the common from the switch and connected it to the ground. In this case it's green. And I've taken the normally open connection from the switch and connected it to the switch terminal so that when you push the momentary button, it connects from the ground to the normally open and causes the relay output to connect whatever you have connected to your circuit. So with the timer, what I did was I connected the battery and the load to the power of the timer. And the ground and the switch on the timer connected to the ground and the switch here so that the timer can send a pulse connecting ground to switch to shut everything off. I hope that's clear. Okay, what I've done is I've pushed the water pump button on. That will activate the water pump and it will start the timer going. Got it set for 15 minutes. So after it clicks off about 14 minutes, I'll show you what happens. All right, we're down about a minute left of the 15. And what's going to happen is when the minute elapses, There will be, the relay will be opened on this timer, which will send a pulse to the trigger over here. And the trigger will disconnect a relay that has the water pump on. So I'm going to pull this camera up and we'll let it count down to about 20, and I'll show you the water pump button, and it should go off 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12.
Any moment now, the 15 minutes will be up. There we go. Shuts it off.
So there you have it. A pretty simple modification, especially if you understand the concept of how the water pump module works, and especially if you've installed auxiliary water pump switches. It's pretty easy to do. You just install the timer as if it were an auxiliary switch, set the parameters, and it will work great. Stay safe. Travato on.